Hi friends, this is Sarvajan here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today, let us discuss how to redistribute between IPv4, that is OSPF and BGP. So R1 I configured as a OSPF routing protocol, and R3 I'm going to configure BGP, and R2 is a border router. So there should be at least one redistribution point to redistribute between OSPF and BGP. So in R2, I have to configure both OSPF routing protocol and BGP routing protocol since it is a border router, right? So now let us, I already configured the directly connected interfaces. Now we have to configure the routing protocol. So before that, let us go to R1 and let us check the interfaces. Show IP interface brief. So these are the interfaces I have defined, 1.1, and also I have defined the loopback address, because that router, that loopback ID is mandatory for configuring the OSPF routing protocol. It requires a router ID, right? So similar way, let us go to R2 and let us check the interfaces. Let us do show IP interface brief. So I already configured the directly connected interfaces, and both interfaces are up. And here also I defined a loopback address. So let us see. So here I have not defined. So we can define a loopback address here also. And let us go to R3 and let us check it out. Show IP interface. So 2.2 is also interface up. And here also we have defined a loopback address 3.3, that is up. So let us define the loopback address in R2. Go to configuration mode. Interface loopback 1. IP address, let us give 2.2.2. Why loopback is mandatory? Because that loopback address will configure as a router ID in OSPF. That is the purpose of configuring the loopback address, right? So let us now go to R1 and let us configure the individual routing protocol. So let us configure the OSPF routing protocol on R1 and BGP on R3. Then let us configure the border router routing protocol. Then we'll configure the redistribution, right? So let us go step by step. Go to router OSPF 100. And what is the network is? 192.168.1.0, right? 192.168.1.0, 0.0.0.255 area 0. And also, if you want network, you can advertise this network also. Loopback address, right? So 1.1.1.0. So we have defined that. Let us do that. Sorry. So then we'll go ahead and configure the BGP. So I have to configure the BGP. So here I establish our autonomous system 65001 and 65002. So I have to establish a EBGB relationship between R2 and R3. So let us configure the EBGB relationship. Go to configuration mode. Let us do router BGP 65001. Neighbor command is 192.168.2.2, and the remote AS is remote AS 65002, right? 65002. That is a neighbor command, and the network let us advertise 192.168.2.0, and let us give the mask as 255.255.255.0, and here define the, yeah, this is the thing we have done. So similar way, let us go to R3 and let us configure. Go to R3 and go to the configuration mode, router BGP 65002, right? 65G, this is 65002. Let us advertise the neighbor. That is, neighbor is 192.168.2.1. This is the neighbor. 2.1 is the neighbor. So the remote AS is 65001, and the network is 192.168.2.0. Mask is 255.255.255.0. So I have to advertise the prefix also. This is a prefix, and this prefix also I have to advertise 3.3.0, right? So the network statement is, this loopback address also I'm advertising 3.3.3.0. So now you're able to see the neighbor is coming up, right? So you can check the neighbor relationship for BGP. Show IP BGP all summary. Yeah, the neighbor is up. Let us check from R3. Show IP BGP all summary. So there are three things we have done. So we have configured OSPF here, and BGP to R2 and R3 I have configured BGP, and R2 again I have to configure this OSPF also since it's a border router. So let us go to R2 again, go to the configuration mode. So router OSPF 100, and the network is, what is the network? It is having 1.0 and 2.0, right? So 192.168. So this is the OSPF. So we have to advertise 1.0. 0.0.0.255 area 0. So, advertise the OSPF network as 1.0, and let us see. So, go to the BGP show run. So everything advertised. Let us see further. Now after before configuring redistribution, I'm just cross verifying the configuration. So router BGP, I have advertised the network 2.0 and also the neighbor statement. Everything I have done right. So now let us check the routing entries. Let us go to R1. Show IP route. So you are able to see the directly connected interfaces, but you are not able to see the other interfaces since I have to perform the redistribution. Go to R3 and let us do show IP route. Right, so still is not there. So let us configure quickly the redistribution. Go to router OSPF 100, redistribute BGP. So BGP out to while redistribution, you have to give this number 65001, right? So go to R2 and redistribute 65001, and then we have to give the keyword subnets, right? Similar way, let us go to our configuration mode and router OSPF. Sorry, router BGP 65001. Then you have to do redistribute OSPF 100. So we are redistributing OSPF and BGP, right? So that's the reason we are doing this OSPF 100. Then we have to do the match. So if you want, you can give the metric. So metric, let us give it as 10. Then match. We have to give the external and the internal, right? So we have done with the configuration. I had also done the redistribution. Let us see now R1. So R1, now I'm able to see the 1.1 series and also I'm able to see the 2.0, but I'm not seeing this prefix 3.3.3, right? Let us see in R1 also, R3, show IP route. So I'm able to see the 1.1 prefix and 3.3 prefix, and also I'm able to see other prefix. Let us ping 1.1.1. I'm able to reach from R1, let us check it out, right? From R1, I have to reach the loopback address of R3. So still I am not able to reach the loopback address of R3. Why? Because in R3 I have to use the keyword connector. So go to the configuration mode. So router BGP 65002. That is autonomous system, right? 65002, and I have to redistribute this connected routes. So in case of BGP, you have to do that. Go to R3 and redistribute connected. So now let us see. Go to R1 and let us check the route. See, now we are able to see the routes, right? Every routes is advertising. So only thing I have to check R1, I have to check this R3, and R3 I have to check R1. Let us see. R1, I am able to ping 3.3.3, and let us ping other interface also, right? 192.168.1.1, 1.2 I am pinging, 2.1 I am able to reach, and 2.2 I am able to reach. So it is successful. Let us check from R3 end, right? R3, let us ping 192.168.1.1, 1.2 I am able to reach. Then what else? Then 192.168.2.1, 2.2, and also I am able to reach 1.1.1. So I am able to see all the prefixes, and also we are able to see the routing entries, right? Show IP route. You can see the routing entries of the in the BGP. You are able to see the 1.1 prefix. That's a BGP table. You can see the BGP prefix, and you are able to see the connected interface, right? And let us see in OSPF routing table, show IP route. So OSPF always the external BGP routes, it will show us OE2, that is external to the OSPF, right? So you will able to see the external routes. Let us go to R1. So that is the routes we are seeing, 3.3, it always advertises external routes. And you are able to see the administrative distance is 110, right? For OSPF 110, it is external route, and you are able to see, right? So this is how we can configure the redistribution between the BGP and OSPF. So I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. Thanks and have a wonderful day. Thank you.